How are you doing, folks? Right, today I'm going to do a Czech Pilsner from the Bible. It's the one that's page 90 of the Greg Hughes book. Show you. Aye, so this one here, I'm going to do this. What I've done is I've put it all into Beersmith. I don't need, I think, 23 layers he's making. 21's plenty for me to get in my keg and all that. So I've readapted it, and also with my Saz hops that I've got a 3.49 instead of the 4.2 in the book. So I've retweaked it all to give me the 4.4%. He's saying 25, I've got around about 26 to use up my, I've got a pack of 100 grams of Saz, so just thought I'll put it late, the late additions here, and just knock these two up. So aye, that should be good. I'm going to get crushing with these grains, and then I'll probably brew later on tonight. Sarah's out, she's a kind of church thing tonight, so it gives me some spare time to just do that and maybe juggle with the kids and that. The Elvis juice has been kegged and it's just conditioning just now, so I had a wee try it, it's quite nice. Not quite nice, it's bloody good. But I will see how that one turns out, and maybe it'll give you a wee taste of it on tonight and get it out. What else? Yeah, that's about it. So we'll look forward to that, and yeah, see you soon. Bye.
Okay, so we're just getting up to temps at the moment, just at 41 degrees. Yeah, I've just got the water recirculating in the HLT, and the mash tun is all ready with the pulse in the mould. 4 kilos. Should be good. Keep saying that. It'll be crap. I've already had a pure disaster. I was milling the Pilsner malt, and it was almost kind of near the end, and the gun get caught, and it like they just kind of yanked and spilled the whole the hopper, like the remainder, and it was all over the floor, and I was like, ah, already pure disaster. So I was about 100 grams, so it's nothing. I'm not that bothered, to be honest, and I'm not even going to open up a fresh bag of kilo bags just to do that, so if it's a wee bit low, I don't care. As long as I get a beer in the end, you know, that tastes good. Should I say, a lager? Something refreshing for the spring coming up. Savage is absolutely roasted today, it was absolutely dynamite. Aye, so, summer's in. We were out playing in the garden as well, so happy days. And then this bad boy will be getting called into action. Aye, so happy days anyway, so looking forward to it. Okay, right, so basically that's me now mashed out at 74 degrees. So plan is now to transfer from my mash tun into my boil kettle, and then I'm going to batch barge, because obviously that seems to work better than flies barge.
It's looking good.
Okay, so hopefully this is my set. I've done 2 batch barges.
Hopefully this is a bit enough. It's just, I think, with the mash tun volume, it tends to work. When you do batch barge, it's a lot more kind of water. So then I was doing the fly spurge with no issue, but now it's batch, it tends to be a bit too loads, so get a good washout and stuff. I was at last time with the Elvis juice, and I didn't realise this, and flipping, next thing I know, there was just water coming at the top of the mash tun. I'm like, what? And it was just because obviously there was more water, and then ended up and the Elvis was a wee bit short, but it's not too bad.
A wee beer for tonight, just the one. This is what I'm planning on using. Bohemian Lager by yeast. Bust the wee smack pack, I'm just going to let that swell up now. So.
Cool. That's us half oil. Time to add the first edition of Fox. Boom.
For some reason my house is smelling like a brewery. I don't know why.
The last edition, got my Irish Moss
and my 10 minutes. Well, I'm going to just put the horse in the main as well. Put him on the hot steam. Hot spider.
This is steam.
Yeah. Oh, right, 10 minutes. Here we go, last one. Heat off. Right. Come on, you. Off. There we go. Give a whack on the cool water. Just do it.
That's it, Charlie.
Here's yours.
36.
This is all ready. Ready to rock. Transfer and roll.
Still need to get the Elvis juice out. I haven't tasted
like
that one's for
this one
done.
Well, here is the Elvis juice. It's starting to clear up. Which is not bad. Got a cake for Thursday or something like that. Now it's Sunday. Give us a bash, see what I
mean. Funny, it's got grapefruit in the aroma, massive. Really punchy. Top notch.
Still bits of it, man. What's this?
Still to clear up. Need to be bits of hop floating about now. Really good. Really sweet caramel type with loads of grapefruit punch on it and grapefruit in the nose. The hell is my calorie? Tiny!
Tiny! What's up?
Oh, that's I need to go and take the oxygen off and then pitch. So I'll be back.
Yeah, sort of topped up anyway. In the fern fridge. And I've set her, she's currently sitting at 22, I've pitched my yeast.
I've set her to something like 16 degrees just to get fermentation started, and then we'll knock it down to about 14 or something. I'll check what it says, but I think that'll probably be up for the next few weeks anyway. See how to take it from there. Right, anyway, back to the Elvis.
So that's how she's looking now.
Yep, thumbs up, do it.
I suppose to get pure milk. Crazy grapefruit, it's awesome. It's not like overwhelming or anything, it's just perfect.
It'll be good. I'll need to do a taste comparison between this, the real Elvis and my mate Dale's Elvis that I brewed at his house. This could be doing with more fizz. Thank you.
Yeah, I'll leave it at that. Hopefully the Pilsner kicks off anyway, and it turns out to be decent. And I'll give you an update on that later. Bye bye! Da ba 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 da doodle da 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 da.